Let us move to the next presentation, the fourth presentation for the day, for the session. Health-related quality of life of patients with diabetic leg and foot ulcers. A.S. Kumarasinghe, S. Wasalathanthri, P. Hettiarachchi, and N. Gunavadana, presented by Mrs. Sriyani A. Kumarasinghe, Department of Health Sciences, the Open University of Sri Lanka.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to share our findings with you. Title of my presentation is Health-related quality of life of patients with diabetic leg and foot ulcers. Diabetes mellitus has become a global health concern due to its increase in worldwide prevalence. Among the complications of diabetes mellitus, foot ulcers create a major socioeconomic impact due to high morbidity and mortality. Diabetic foot ulcers are badly affected on patients' physical and mental health status. Because of these wounds, patients experience restricted mobility, and it leads to limit their social activities, increase family tension, lost time to work, and restrict their leisure time. These patients are extremely anxious about the wounds. As a result, these patients have low self-esteem. Previous research have shown that diabetic foot ulcers negatively influence the health-related quality of life of these patients. Socio-demography factors such as female gender, increase in age, low education, unemployment, living alone, clinical factors such as presence of DM complications, leg being the site of ulcer, having high-grade ulcers are found to be some of the factors affecting health-related quality of life of these patients. In Sri Lanka, limited studies have reported in relation to assessing quality of life of patients in different aspects, but no studies assessing quality of life of these patients. Justification of the study. In fact, assessing quality of life of these patients enables healthcare providers to identify patient problems and get patient specific information, and can consider patient preferences when planning treatment, can provide individualized care to patients, actively involve patients in managing ulcers. Objectives were in this study to evaluate health-related quality of life of patients with diabetic leg and foot ulcers and to examine association between health-related quality of life and socio-demographic and clinical characteristics. This was a descriptive cross-sectional study conducted at Colombo North Teaching Hospital during the period of June to December 2014. Purposive sampling technique was used to recruit patients and studied 140 patients. Adult diabetic leg and foot ulcer patients admitted to the surgical wards with wound duration more than 2 weeks were recruited for the study. Ethical approval for the study was obtained from the University of Sri Jayawardenepura, and voluntary participated patients were participated voluntary and signed informed consent prior to participation. Interview administered questionnaires were used. Baseline data were collected about age, gender, education level, employment status, presence of those were obtained from interviewing the patient, and medical records were used to take presence of comorbidities like hypertension, PVD, neuropathy, retinopathy, and poor vision. It is a self-reported one. Ulcer history, duration, and site also recorded. Health-related quality of life was assessed using SF36, short form health survey questionnaire. This questionnaire consists of 36 questions and they were grouped into 8 domains. Each question scored on a scale of 0 to 100. Collected percentage of scores of each domain denotes high quality of life, denotes by high scores, vice versa. Validity of reliability of this instrument well established in international and local setting, and single version of the tool was used. A two-factored model of SF36 was used to assess quality of life of the patients. 8 domains of the SF36 divided into physical component score and mental component score as shown in this figure. SPSS version 21 was used for statistical analysis. Demographic and clinical characteristic of the patient was described by descriptive statistics. Association between variables determined by Mann-Whitney U-test. Results of the study. Mean age was 58 with SD 10 years. Mean duration was 9.5 years. And male-female difference was not approximately equal. And education, and considerable education, 50% of patients had 10 year less than 10 years education. 36% of patients had retinopathy and poor vision. 34% of patients had hypertension. 36% of patients had neuropathy. And 7% of patients has PVD. This shows about ulcer history and characteristics. 80% of patients had previous ulceration. And most common ulcer site was the foot. And 77% of patients had less or equal 10 weeks of wound duration. According to quality of life scores, health-related quality of was reported to be low in the patients with in the sample. Total quality of life score was 46 and plus or minus 18 points with range 16 to 87. Similarly, previous studies also shown poor health-related quality of life in patients with diabetic ulcers. This shows scores according to two-factored model. Physical component scores and mental component score were low. And patients' physical health is more deprived than their mental health. And similar findings has reported in the literature. Findings indicated lower health-related scores for women than men. Total scores, physical and mental component scores were significantly different in these two groups. Unemployed had lower health-related life scores than employed. Total scores and physical component scores were significantly different, but no different was observed in mental component score. Health-related quality of life scores were low in patients with retinopathy and poor vision than in those with unimpaired vision. Health-related quality of life scores were low in patients with hypertension than normotensive patients. Total scores, physical and mental component scores were significantly different. And similarly, previous studies have shown this kind of findings. Also, we have observed that health-related quality of life scores were low in patients with leg ulcers than those with foot ulcers. Previous studies also shown low quality of life in patients with leg ulceration. However, in this study, we didn't see any association between health-related quality of life with patients' age, education level, whether the patients live on their own. In conclusion, diabetic ulcers have a negative impact on health-related quality of life of patients. Both physical and mental health were affected, and female gender, unemployment, presence of visual impairment, and retinopathy, hypertension, and leg being the site of the ulcer were significant factors associated with poor health-related quality of life. Authors wish to recommend, based on our findings, to consider the patient's physical and mental health status when planning, evaluating and managing diabetic ulcer patients, and to use a holistic approach to assess the overall impact of diabetic ulcers on patients' life and provide necessary support in improving quality of life. And these are the references. And thank you very much for listening.
If you have any doubts, you can clear them now.